I filed my claim at federal court, in my court, and I made a mistake and included a person who was not diverse, and they dismissed it on like January 29th. So on February 4th, I refiled it, amending it to get rid of the person that was not diverse. And then
the person wasn't diverse?
Because they was in the same state. I made a mistake including someone in the same city as me.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. Were you going after a man or were you going after a state actor?
Going after this, it was three people. It was a man, the CFO of a corporation, two corporations, and then the last person who signed a document trying to do something to my property, administrate my property. So I included them. And then there was another person that was here that was a person that I was going after. And that person happened to be living here in Las Vegas.
I'm trying to follow you, man. It's kind of complicated, man. I'm trying to figure out what you're talking about.
Okay. All right. I had the wrongdoer was two corporations and a person, a man, a woman, shall I say. And the woman was not diverse because they lived in the same, they live in Las Vegas as well. Okay. So when...
So if you file as a man, you can't sue a corporation. You always file against another man.
Okay, so...
Did you do that or didn't you do that? I mean, Bob could sue Joe, but Joe can't sue a pine cone.
Right, okay, the pine cone. So the man that controls the corporation, you can sue him.
Right. You sue the guy who threw the pine cone. You don't sue the pine cone.
Right, which is what I did. I put the guy's name, the CFO, who controls the pine cone name for the corporation.
Right.
And then the person that wasn't, the woman that wasn't diverse was not connected to a corporation. So I just had her name on there, and she was not diverse. So they dismissed it for lack of subject matter jurisdiction, and then I refiled it like 6 days later. And then the magistrate, when I was in the midst of reserving my amended case, the magistrate he quashed the other parties submitted a motion to quash, and he said he was going to grant it because there was nothing before the court because the case had been dismissed on the 29th, which means he was ignoring my new filing on the 4th. So what I did was I sent a letter.
Okay, I guess like I said, if I could actually see what you filed, it would probably make more sense. Because like I said, you say your name is Malcolm, right?
Right, Malcolm Brooks, yeah.
Okay, and then you were the claimant, you were the prosecutor. What did you call yourself on that?
I call myself the aggrieved party prosecutor. I am man.
The aggrieved party prosecutor.
Prosecutor. Uh-huh.
Okay, just right. You just say, right. You just say prosecutor. You don't have to do aggrieved. Aggrieved you can put down at the bottom.
Okay.
Fine. But, and then who did you put down underneath you in that caption?
Underneath, as far as the wrongdoers, it's me and my wife on the claim together. We both are I a man, I a woman. Green Party prosecutors, and then
what I'm trying to say, okay, let me try to stop that right in its tracks again, too. I understand if you're making a claim that somebody's done you wrong, and
uh-huh.
your wife's claiming that somebody's done you wrong, that's two separate cases.
Oh, okay, so we should have filed separately.
Right, of course, because to me it's like, you know, I claim that I believe in God, and you claim you believe in God. Yeah, but your version of God is not going to be the same as mine.
Right, okay, I got you.
Whatever's in your mind is not going to be what's in my mind. No matter how close we are related, and even if we're identical twins, I guarantee my belief or what I think God looks like or does or should or should not do is going to be different than what you believe. So two people standing on the same claim makes it kind of tough. You see what I'm saying?
Right, okay.
You know, I mean, in the legal world, you could have 10,000 people, you know, filing a lawsuit. That's fine, you know. You could have one of these ridiculous class action lawsuits. That's fine, you know, where 10,000 people sue and they get $10,000 and everybody owes the attorney $50 when it's all said and done. you know.
No, okay.
But like I said, when you make a claim, make a claim. You know what I'm saying? You
okay.
could say, you know, your wife was impacted by it as well. That's fine. And, you know, she wishes to. She can make a claim. But I don't speak for her. You know, she's her own person. She's her own being.
Oh, okay.
You know, it's like, are you forcing her to make this? Is this under her own free will? See, because before women used to get married, the judge would bring them into a into their office and ask them, you know, when they went to a justice of the peace, are you marrying this man because he promised you money? Did your daddy sell you? You know, did your daddy promise him something? Do you really want to marry this man? And if the woman says, no, I don't want to marry this man, it's arranged, or I don't want to be part of this, the judge would just, you know, come back out and say, okay, that's fine. I won't tell him what you said. And then the judge would just come out and say, oh, the clerk's office is closed right now. The clerk got sick or whatever. I don't have the paperwork that I need, you know, or whatever. You're going to have to come back later on, and we'll see if we can pick it up from there. You know, that's what I'm saying, because the judge would take a woman in the back and ask her, you really want to be in part of this?
Right.
But like I said, if you're making a claim, and then say you and your wife get into an argument for whatever reason between here and whenever, and before it comes to court, and then the judge just says, you really want to be part of this? And she's like, no, man, he's you know, he's a wackadoo. I don't want nothing to do with this.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I tell people, make it on their own.
Right, so if they can separate us, then it could be a problem, is what you're saying.
It will be a problem, like I said.
Yeah.
You know, so like I said, you let her file one, you file one. She puts it in her words, you put it in your words. That's why I tell people, don't cut, copy, and paste my stuff. Put it in your own damn words.
Right.
Because then it just looks like you're a zombie. It just sounds like you're just a follower. You're just like a little slave to whatever. You're just doing what you're told to do. Like you're being indoctrinated, like, oh, I agree, it's man, Malcolm, prosecutor's like, oh, Jesus, Lord, that looks like a Karl Lentz statement there.
Right.
So Malcolm came up on his own, that's for sure. So then you look at your stuff, it's like, oh, yeah, well, whatever, you know, he just cut, copy, and pasted. You know, you got to stand on. Everybody's got to stand on their own.